Welcome to Dark Knight Films Reviews. I am your host, Matt Spies, and today we are looking at Friday the 13th, the final chapter, released in 1984. Friday the 13th, the final chapter, stars Ted White, Corey Feldman, Kimberly Beck, Eric Anderson, Crispin Glover, Barbara Howard, Joan Freeman, Peter Barton, Judy Aronson, Camilla Moore, Carrie Moore, Lawrence Monison, Bruce Mahler, Lisa Freeman, and is directed by Joseph Zito. Now, this film directly follows the ending to part three. And it looks as though Jason is dead and he is being taken to the morgue. Of course, he is not dead and he revives just in time to kill a horn dog of a coroner named Axel. This character is a great character in here. He's just, for the time he's on screen, he just is very memorable. Bruce Mahler does a great job with this character. And his little relationship with Lisa Freeman's Nurse Morgan is just perfect. So when you get past this opening, that's when Joseph Zito goes into a mode that most of these Friday the 13th films don't go. You actually have a kid in a Friday the 13th film, in Corey Feldman's Tommy. The only film in this series that has had a kid in it so far has been the original Friday the 13th, and that was only in the 1955 flashback scene in which we see Pamela walking around through her point of view and we see the kids sleeping. Here, we have an actual kid in a Friday the 13th film, and he is a major part of the storyline. This film has the strongest Jason Voorhees performance of the entire series with Ted White. Ted White just brought a different vibe to the Jason role. Gone was just the big hulking, stupid brute of the previous film from Richard Brooker. Ted White's Jason is slightly smaller in size, but much more deadly. When he kills, it comes out of nowhere. You very seldom see it coming, so it's a really great, he's really great at scaring the audience, which Richard Brooker, you saw him coming whenever he was coming as Jason. You knew he was going to attack. There was no real scares in Richard Brooker's Jason. Ted White portrays him with the limited screen time that he has, with an intensity and a cruelness that he's the only Jason that's ever had this. I mean, most other Jasons, yes, they kill and everything, but aside from Kane Hodder, no Jason has ever really fully enjoyed killing the way that Ted White's Jason does. Kimberly Beck is pretty amazing playing Corey Feldman's Tommy's sister Trish, as is their mother, Joan Freeman. The whole cast, all around the board, is amazing in this. Joseph Zito he put together a good ensemble in this. It's probably the best acting that the series has ever had, as far as all around the board, great acting in a film. Joseph Zito's direction on the kills, on the dialogue, on anything is excellent in this film. Crispin Glover is Jimmy. He is the sympathetic member of these group of horn dog teens that are going up to this cabin for the weekend just to have sex and have fun, you know. And his character is the shy and horny at the same time guy, and yet he is the likely one that you're in a normal Friday the 13th film, he would be the one that would be almost the survivor or the final guy that's going to try and save the girl. And his scenes with Lawrence Monison's Ted, they just have really good chemistry working off of each other. I mean, and until Crispin Glover has sex, I mean, it appears he's going to be safe in this film until he gets together with Tina. And speaking of Tina, Camilla Moore and Casey Moore, I mean, the double mint freaking twins, for Christ's sakes. They were known for those commercials on TV. They weren't known for actors in these films. These twins were really good in this. It's so surprising to have the, you know, really good performances from both of these girls, when all you had seen of them prior to this was in those commercials. But, and the prettiest man on the screen, of course, is Peter Barton. And he's basically the leader of this group of horn dog kids and everything. And his little relationship with Barbara Howard is a really good little moment in here, too. The other good performance in this is, of course, Judy Aronson as Samantha. Her scenes with Barbara Howard, Sarah, are really, she's the more, really sex-driven, more the slutty, I guess, character amongst them. And, of course, Sarah is the more innocent type. And like I said, if Kimberly Beck's Trish was not in here, Barbara Howard's Sarah would probably be your final girl. But again, she makes the cardinal sin of having sex as well. Thanks a lot, Peter Barton's Doug. You caused her death. But overall, this is the best Friday the 13th film that was ever released, in my opinion. It is the perfect storm of great direction from Joseph Zito and excellent performances by all of the cast, all around the board, and a kick-ass strong portrayal of Jason, as I said, with Ted White. His moments near the end, he is a threat. Kimberly Beck's Trish is literally almost killed several moments. There is no moments where she's just able to knock him on his ass and beat the shit out of him the way that Chris Higgins did on Jason in Part 3. The one time where they do knock his ass out with big TV set being dropped on his freaking head, it's an understandable scene. And even then, he's still strong, portrayed as strong in that scene. So, Ted White is one of the best Jasons of all time. He will be greatly missed. Very sad when I heard last year, near the end of last year, that he had passed away. But my rating of Friday the 13th, the final chapter, I give this film a 9.5 out of 10. This is almost the absolute perfect of the Friday the 13th films, in my opinion. It should have been the final chapter. This was such a great ending to this series that if they would have ended it here, I would have loved it, because this was the epitome of how to do a film and do it right. But what do you think? What do you think of this film? Do you agree with my review? Do you disagree? Let me know in the comments down below. And as usual, do not forget to like, share, and subscribe, because it really does help this channel out a lot. And stick around, because this is the beginning of the last week of a marathon of films. So, I hope that you will join me in tomorrow's video as well. Thanks for watching.